Great shot of the nose. I see you've been keeping your nostrils clean, Clementine. That's good. Nothing's more frustrating than unclean nostrils.
Who's playing bouncy ball right now?
Uh-oh.
Bleh. Oh. Just the rope. Oh, hi.
I wonder who that is. Is it Kenny?
Talk or gun?
Yeah, let's talk.
Who's Hello? There?
Oh, hey, it's Shitstain.
Oh. Hey, Mike. We cool?
Easy. Easy now.
Step back.
Clem. Shit.
What are you doing?
I got the rest of it. Clem.
You fucking bitch!
We're just leaving. Now keep it down, alright?
That's everything we have.
That's everything we have.
You're gonna fucking leave us to die out here and you wanna take the moral high ground?
Away from that guy, Clem, okay?
Who? Kenny?
By taking all of our supplies and leaving us to go fuck ourselves? And you, Bonnie.
Let's just go.
Damn it, Mike. I thought you were cool.
All right, Clem.
Now I'm gonna You're taking armor with you. Slow,
and you're gonna give me the gun, okay? And then we'll talk.
Why are you doing
Why
this?
Why are you doing this?
He didn't give us any choice.
Он злой человек.
I'm sorry, Clem.
Oh, you shut
Just
up.
Just give me the gun, Clem.
This is a first strike for Mike. Give gun.
Shoot.
Threaten.
There we go.
Oh.
Ooh.
Okay.
It's fine. Just
No!
That was fucking Arvo, wasn't it?
Yeah, so you're retroactively right about Arvo.
Yeah, see?
God, Mike, you have to go.
And now he takes off.
Just leave her.
You know what he is? He's a Russian... Oh man, not Ben. What was the other guy? The dude that got somebody shot when I told him he would?
Ah, shit.
Yeah, he's Zambambified.
Yeah.
Oh, it better not end there. Oh, don't
On
you fucking
season
end
three
there.
Of The Walking Dead. Surprise! It was all just a dream!
Yeah.
Lee's fine!
What happened? Oh, Lee? What? Lee?
Lee?
It's just a bad dream, sweet pea.
Or this is a dream. Way too good of a dream.
What was it about?
Oh, that's fucking Ben. Speak of the devil.
He's bit.
We don't know how this works yet. Maybe it's like a cold. His mom's a doctor.
Maybe he's going to die. It's not like a cold. He's gonna die.
But my brother always had something.
He's going to die. I know it.
I've seen the future. Only two people in this van are alive.
Why?
I called him a crybaby when I hid the bug in his pillow.
Oh, that's okay, honey. He didn't mean it.
Lee?
Hmm?
Why did Lily do that to Carly?
I don't know.
I'm quiet because this is actually really fucking emotional.
She was sad,
yeah.
Clem. That can make people angry sometimes.
Because of her dad? That's a dumb reason. Have you ever...
ever been that angry?
You ever been that angry?
Yeah. One time.
Just once. He went to prison for it. Well, he was on his way to prison.
Always makes sense.
Then who knew the world ended?
How come?
Because bad things happen to everyone. And it's hard to keep being yourself after they do. What do you think? Should we have left her behind?
No.
No.
Maybe we should have. I don't know. I don't know if we did the right thing.
How can you tell?
Well, it's not.
He says he doesn't know, so he's not gonna have an answer.
Isn't the right answer.
I hate math.
Oh, well, there you go. I hate math. Math was actually my strongest subject.
Part of growing up is doing what's best for the people you care about. Even if sometimes that means hurting someone else.
I don't want to hurt anyone.
It's not that easy.
I'm scared, Lee.
What can I tell you to make it better?
That you're alive and this isn't a dream. That you won't leave me, that'll be okay.
That you won't leave me.
Yeah, let's make that even more heart-wrenching.
That. I promise.
I've been made promises before!
Everything's gonna be alright.
Oh, the fucking turn of the knife. This really fucking hurts!
Well, let's try to get some sleep.
Okay, Lee.
So, like, is this going to be insidious where she's going to have a dream where she goes back to the parents that we never actually got to have dialogue with?
Just keep going down in dream layers.
Until the man in white spanks her.
Until she gets down to Creepy Thomas level.
Fuck you, bitch. I'm going to cut you, bitch.
Then you have that long dialogue puzzle of getting him to come to terms with himself.
Please don't end there.
Season 3
on
of
the
Walk. Okay.
Slow down!
Shut up!
So we've now had two dream sequences that go back to that scene.
She's
we have the
awake.
One just now, and then back in Season 1 where Clem was zombied.
Yeah. Wasn't that Lee's, though?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Both Lee and Clem have had dreams involving that fucking RV.
Oh, thank God.
You passed out from the shock.
What happened?
That piece of shit Rusky shot you.
We had to run the truck to keep you warm. How do you feel?
It hurts.
Couldn't find the bullet. Must have gone clean through. It'll burn a while, but you'll be fine.
Those sons of bitches. I mean, I expected it from the Russian. But Mike? I could tell
I actually wasn't expecting Mike to do that.
I didn't think he'd go that far.
I should have done something. Is Bonnie okay? I can't believe they did that. Yeah, I can't believe they did that.
Like that in the first place.
I can't believe they did that.
I don't think they knew what they were doing, except trying to get away.
Yeah, well, they're gone now. Good fucking riddance.
Now that Clem's awake, we should talk about where we're going.
We're headed north.
What, to find Wellington?
Oh, boy.
You sure talk a lot of shit, but you got a better plan?
We head south, back to House.
Carver's camp? The fuck kind of plan is that?
I think Bonnie said there
Wellington
was more formula
out there.
And we actually know
back.
Where it is.
And it was overrun
stop
by a damn herd.
I don't care where we go. Just please, stop arguing.
She's the one that's going off.
Because you won't listen to a thing I'm saying.
What's that? You're talking into my bad ear, sweetheart.
Jackass.
Oh, I still can't hear you.
Look, even if there is
I'd be
here,
lying if I said I wasn't enjoying this.
It. We could get back to House in a day.
Tell you what, we can turn around just as soon as you pry this wheel from my cold, dead fingers. How's that sound?
Ah, man.
Whatever. I give up.
Get your feet off the dash.
Let's play a game, Clem. I spy with my little eye an asshole. Your turn.
Grow up.
Go to hell.
I'll pull this fucking car over.
Go ahead.
You want to die out here?
Better than waiting to die.
Leave him alone, Jade.
Don't touch him, Kenny.
I couldn't see the damn road.
Bet you're having trouble seeing a lot of things these days.
You shut your fucking mouth. I am done playing games with you, Jane.
Fuck you. You don't know a damn thing about me.
Oh, I know exactly what you are. Nothing. Nobody cares about you. And you don't care about nobody but yourself. That makes you nothing.
What is
That's
it with you?
Some self-projection there, Kenny.
It's your family, right?
Don't.
It is, isn't it?
I'm warning you, you little shit.
You're just another type A asshole trying to save a bunch Watch of people.
Watch the road. This
Don't
ain't
you
the time
fucking
for that.
Talk about them.
This isn't the time for this.
No, this is exactly the time for this.
You listen to me. You mouth off about my family, and I will fucking end you.
Jesus Christ, I'm so sick of this wounded warrior crap. Just pull over. I can't take this.
What? Running away again? What a fucking shocker. In the end, still only care about yourself, right?
And where were you when Sarita died, Kenny? Huh?
Oh,
where
man.
Were you?
I was there. I couldn't...
This is
God
crazy.
Damn you, I love that woman!
Who could love you?
It's Look nobody's you. Fault.
You can't raise this kid. It's scared to death of you.
Nobody who died is anyone's fault. We all wanted to be together, and it just went bad. But we owe it to them to try to make the best of this.
I'm sorry, Clem, but I can't put up with this bullshit anymore.
Oh, the feeling's mutual.
You know the thing about people like you, Kenny? You're just a bomb waiting to go off. Everyone talks about you behind your back because they're afraid of you.
That ain't true.
Mike, Bonnie, Sarita.
Fucking liar, that ain't true.
Everyone around you knows that sooner or later, they're gonna end up dead. Sarita knew it, I know it, and so does Clementine.
I told you not to talk about my family.
Fuck you.
You fucking piece of shit.
Go to hell, you son of a bitch.
Jesus.
Uh-oh. Round and round and round we go.
You okay?
I'm fine.
How's AJ?
He's fine.
You sure?
Yes.
Clem, you all right?
Yeah.
Kenny, I'm...
Wait, hold on.
Go around.
One of them might have diesel.
We shouldn't stop here.
We're running on fumes. Got no choice. When I holler, it's okay. Drive up closer. Anything happens.
It keeps getting more and more white.
Right.
Welcome to America.
Going? Go now.
Stay here. I'm going with you. Did I not press it in time?
Nope. Nope. He will cut you off no matter what you try and say.
Well, that's
fucking asshole. God. I can't do this.
God,
anymore.
That argument is the tensest thing in this game.
I don't know how to get through
tried,
to him.
Just
stop
can't.
Making him mad.
You're both losing it. Clem, everyone's like that around him. You know that.
I'm not.
Clem, we could leave. Right now. Are you serious?
No.
What about AJ? Look, I know you're close to him, but Kenny would never let him go. This is our chance, Clem. Don't you ever want to know what it's
no.
like to live
they,
your own
see,
life?
See, that's what Mike and Bonnie were doing. Uh-oh. Ran into trouble.
It's snowing. Why are they moving?
They must not be cold enough yet. Fuck!
Get us out of here!
I don't know how to drive!
See that pedal on the floor? Step on it! Don't just sit there!
Just do it. Alright, now for the driving minigame! Oh, jeez! Hey, how's it going? Hey, no hitchhikers! No! That's bad.
Get out
Jane!
Of the door is stuck! Shit! Shit!
Of course.
There are
Bang!
Them.
I'm trying
hurry.
To. It, no, you need to highlight
Get
the thing. You need to highlight the door.
Jane.
Uh oh.
Jane, wait.
Hi, friend. No, no, my shoe. No.
Boop. Bullet. Also known
Jane.
As little steel pellets of death.
Also known as zombie solvers.
This is kind of like the beginning of the episode.
Yeah.
Now it ends? Ah, oh, man, this is... This is tense!
Well, as interesting as this is, we just know that you're going to fight a really disappointing boss fight that's just a rehash of a previous boss fight when you get to the end of this.
Lee?
Bang.
Hope that wasn't Kenny. Or Jane.
Now it's Zen Bimby. You're fine.
Yeah.
No, I meant the twin pets. The two black cats. I forget their names. Ivory King.
Oh, those.
Yeah. Well, time for a death march across Siberia, I guess.
Hopefully Arvo is one of these so I can shoot him.
Boop. I don't know, I kind of want Arvo here. It's like, hey Arvo, this is like a Tuesday for you, isn't it?
Ugh.
Guide us through the snow, Siberian man.
I'd rather shoot him and take the risk. And I still don't know what happened to Bonnie and Mike.
This is like last weekend when I was at Siberian death camp. I mentioned democracy and did not spit when I said it.
Build an igloo.
But the Eskimos don't have to put up with this shit. You know, I think one of the best places to be in a zombie apocalypse is fucking Mongolia.
Mongolia. I don't know, I'll take that flying fortress that the shield agents built.
Yeah, a shield helicarrier or fucking, shit, what's the name of the city from BioShock Infinite?
Oh, I haven't played that game, so I have no idea.
Columbia. Yeah.
Columbia?
A helicarrier or Columbia, or hell, even, well, Rapture is a kind of a shithole, but Columbia would be fine. I mean, sure, you'd have to put up with a lot of white supremacist racist assholes, but, like, I don't know, I'd take racist assholes over zombies.
What was that?
That's a door. The visitor center.
Oh.
Any port in the storm, you know?
I hope there aren't zombies in here.
Or there's a manageable number of zombies. Because I bet the noise of the wind would cover up your gunshots pretty effectively.
Yeah.
Jane? Kenny?
You all right?
Hey, Kenny.
Yeah.
I ain't dead yet.
Where's the kid?
He's with her.
You left him with her? Jane?
Didn't have much of a choice. Uh-oh.
Jane!
Oh, you can hear the music ramping up.
I really hope Jane isn't dead.
Wait.
Good news. Jane is not dead.
Oh, thank Christ.
Hi, Jane.
Jane!
How you doing?
Where's the kid? Jane!
Oh, no.
Where is he?
Did you have to use the get-out-of-jail-free card? What did you do? Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Kenny, please? Don't do it.
What are you saying? No. No!
No. Not again. Not again.
Clem, look at me. No matter what happens, just stay out of it.
Oh, no. Okay. Stay out of just what? I don't understand. How could you stay out of what?
What?
I think I know where this is going, but I have to ask.
You have to trust me. You're gonna see what he really is.
This game tailors itself to the choices you make.
Uh-oh. Shit. Jane, get out of here.
Get out of here, Clem. Now!
Get out of my way.
Kenny?
How did you kill a fucking child?
I didn't kill him! It was an accident, Kenny! I won't back down from you, Kenny.
Shut up!
Kenny, let her talk!
Kenny, let her talk!
I'm done talking, Clem!
Clem, stay back. Don't you come near me, you son of a bitch. Kenny! Get the fuck up!
Oh, hitting the wound! Please don't. No, stop. Please.
Stop. Please.
Oh, man.
Arm or knee?
Jane! Asshole! Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
This is all your fucking fault!
Piece of shit!
Just go.
And bite my tongue.
I ain't going nowhere.
Get between them. Get between them!
your...
No, run. Stop it.
What happened? Please. Move.
I'll fucking kill you.
Ooh. Oh. Look at what you're doing. Stop, it's over.
Stop. It's over. Listen to me.
Get her off.
Shit!
Oh,
man.
God damn it!
Okay. Aw, oh, fuck.
I only have one thing to say about what's happening right now.
Choose wisely.
I knew you would.
What do you do?
I press A again. Oh man,
what do you do?
Look away.
Or shoot cannon.
Oh man, I don't want Jane to die though.
So when you asked if Jane dies...
Oh man.
The answer is, you have a choice.
I didn't want to shoot Kenny.
Okay?
I tried to get in between them. Yeah. I tried.
Yeah, I think so.
So you have now officially locked off one of the three endings of this episode. Hey, Kenny. So,
Clem,
how you doing?
You made the right choice.
Good.
Oh, wow.
I let you down.
You did.
I let everyone down.
Why did you make me do it then? Just hang
just
on.
Hang on, Kenny. Please.
No. No. You're better off without me.
I agree with this statement.
We almost made it. We were close, weren't we? I thought...
I bet that baby's alive.
Asked for it so many times. Now that it's happening, I'm scared.
Most people usually are. You're going to be okay.
I'm
Why did you do this? Why did you do this?
Do this.
I'm sorry, darling. I'm so sorry.
Looks like we're gonna have to put that knife to use.
Double tap.
Don't want to be a Zambambo McHappy meal.
No open caskets in this universe.
To be fair, Kenny looks ugly as shit anyway right now with that eye looking like that.
I would just end the statement at Kenny looks ugly as shit.
I know you would. You can't stand Kenny.
Oh god.
Yep. Baby's alive.
So AJ is fine.
Yeah, I figured as much. She didn't seem as helpless as she was looking when she got inside. The only problem, though, is that with Kenny dead, we kind of don't have anybody that has any actual experience with kids.
I understand if you're upset. AJ was never in any danger. I was just going to try to talk you into coming with me. I just thought if you saw Kenny like that, you'd know we'd have to leave him. Look, Clem, I'm sorry.
You're fucking crazy. I can't believe he's alive.
But it's over
now. I can't
now.
Believe he's alive.
I can't believe he's alive. He's safe, Clem. It was a stupid thing. I should never have lied to you. But I thought it was the only way you'd see. Oh my god. Kenny, you have to forgive me. Please.
Oh, shit. They didn't double tap him.
Behind us. Please. I did it for you.
I forgive you, Jane. If I get rid of you, I'm on my own.
I forgive you, Jane.
Okay. So you have ended up with
Thank
the
you.
Same ending I got.
Thank you, Clem. You were right about Kenny. All along, you knew what he was gonna do. It's over now, Clem. Let's just put all this behind us.
It was a stupid plan, though. I mean, while they were fighting, a Zambambo could have walked right up to that car.
Yup. So, this, the two choices you just made, are the most fucking divisive choices I've ever seen in a video game. Reddit and 4chan's V exploded after this came out, with so many people violently arguing in favor of one or the other.
Oh, 9 days later.
Yeah, we get an epilogue.
Not 28 days later. Excuse me.
Nope. You go back to the house.
It made the most sense. We knew where it was. It wasn't that far away. And we knew it had a buttload of supplies, assuming that the couple people that were still alive...
Yeah, and only has a few rendering issues, so reality is fairly stable here compared to the rest of this fucking universe.
The only problem is that Bonnie and Mike also know where this place is.
Hey, Carver. You're looking good.
It's better than being a zombie.
I'm glad you didn't have to see that happen.
I've seen worse.
I've seen worse.
Yeah, I don't think anything is ever going to top I Shot Lee.
Clem, this formula.
It wasn't as gruesome, but emotionally, it's...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Turn that fucking knife. Salt the wound afterwards.
Is in good shape.
You know, that's perhaps the one good thing that came out of that.
See how it goes.
Other than zombie Lee never happening. But is the fact that no matter what I go through, I've been through worse.
Oh, hey, look. Pebbles. Hello, Pebbles.
Come on.
Who is it?
They don't look armed.
New people.
This your place?
Yeah.
We're just past through. Yeah, it is.
Go away.
Really?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why? We need help.
My boy, he ain't doing so good.
What's wrong with him?
Look, don't worry. He ain't bit. Just hungry. We've been walking for weeks. Ran out of food a couple days back. That your kid?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where you girls been?
I'm teen and pregnant.
Where I was. Why do you care?
Whoa, I didn't mean nothing by it.
You don't want to know? Everywhere. All over.
All over.
You, been up north?
Yeah.
Yeah, us
fucking
too.
Fucking sucks.
Keep your eye on him.
This place needs a lot of work.
Yeah?
Yeah, we could help you.
There's not that much food left. Please.
Give him a chance.
We won't make it another night out here.
Look, I know you don't know us, and I know a lot of people out here say a lot of things. But I'm asking you, as a
don't
father, please, don't turn us away.
I don't know, Clem.
I don't look like your kid.
It could be anybody.
And again, Lee.
Do we really want to go through this again?
Please.
Invite them in.
Here. Come in. Thank you. Around the side.
You
sure
about this?
That sneaky cat feet pose.
This place is a mess. And I don't
it's
know
going
how
to be
long
okay.
that food will last.
I'm not sure about anything.
It'll take a lot of work.
We can start.
I'm not sure about anything anymore. It's not much, but we'll make it better.
Just keep your eyes on him. We'll be fine.
So, don't mind the corpses. We're in the middle of renovating.
Youth rocket.
Oh. Need a little tidying up,
My
but you know...
Patricia.
Poach some potpourri out and we'll be fine.
Thank you, Jane.
Don't mention it.
Thank you so much.
Bet you haven't had one of those in a long while.
We are friends now, you and I. Hey? Hey, you said you weren't armed.
Cool hat.
You have no idea.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay. So that's the end.
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 Okay. It's that. That's the end, everybody.
Yeah. So here is the breakdown of the three endings, because I'm sure you're very interested in how this ends. If no matter what, you get the choice with the baby at the end. Yeah.
So protected the baby.
Yeah. Everyone went for the baby. Most people were smart and didn't go to Luke, because that's the bad decision.
Yeah, that sucks. He dies no matter what.
Yeah. No one fucking went with Mike.
Yeah. Like, what would happen if you did actually pick to go with Mike?
Arvo would get an itchy trigger finger and shoot you anyway.
Oh, so no matter what, you get shot.
Yeah. No, there's no changing the outcome of that.
Yep.
The split on Kenny and Jane is 50-50, and the explosions on the message boards are so intense on the fight with them. Now, that 21% looks really fucking low, but it is a three-way split. So this is the minority vote, and it's been that for the longest time. This is the least common ending people get. Though it's the ending both of us got, and it's the ending every Let's Player I've watched that played through this blind ended up getting. I've only heard people going with the Kenny ending. But the Kenny ending, you shoot Jane, you get to the car, and... Well, he stabs Jane, and you get to the car.
Yeah.
And you're given the choice of, now that all the facts are, go with him or not. It is a lot easier to go with Kenny after finding the baby than go with Jane after finding the baby.
Yeah.
If you go with Kenny, you continue north, and you do get to Wellington. Wellington does exist.
Oh.
But they say that too many people have been showing up, and supplies are low. So, oh my god, I forgot it's a four-way split with this. Once you're up there at Wellington, they give you the choice. They have room for Clementine and the baby, but not Kenny.
Oh.
So you can either go live in Wellington or go off into the woods with Kenny. That's the Kenny ending. The other ending is you get to the baby and whoever's left standing, you tell them, you're a murderous psychopath. Go fuck yourself. And that applies to both of them. Jane and Kenny are both terrible people.
I was going to say that fight, because like Kenny was going off on her, but Jane was doing the same thing. She wasn't doing anything to help the situation.
Kenny is an unstable time bomb. He answers his problems with violence. And you consistently see that throughout both seasons of the game. He always fights first. He's a very aggressive person. Jane, on the other hand, is a very manipulative person who saw this. She didn't want to deal with it, but she wants you, and she doesn't care where your loyalty stands. She's trying to manipulate the system so you go with her.
Yeah.
And she sets him off intentionally and pushes him over the edge.
Yeah.
Now, it is really hard to argue, and I have seen tons of arguments, which of them is in the right, because they're both shitty people.
I think in that instance, they were both wrong. There was no right.
There was no right, but the question is, who was less wrong than the other? The guy who went up to the edge, or the girl who pushed him off?
Yeah.
If you tell them to fuck off, Clementine will take the baby, go off on her own, and the last scene you see is her seeing a horde of walkers. She kills one of them, covers herself and the baby in guts, and walks into the herd.
Ugh.
Yeah. So those are your endings, and everyone thought... you can go ahead and continue on.
Continuing.
I think we get one big recoup, and I'll finish my thoughts during the credits. Recap, not recoup.
My words.
Nope, straight to credits. You don't get...
Straight to credits.
Oh, right, that's up to the credits. Anyway, so everyone thought that this was the end of the Walking Dead games, or even Clementine's story. Because those endings branch off in radically different directions, because you have five permutations of an ending here.
Yeah.
You have go with Jane, refuse to let those people in, go with Jane, let those people in, go off on your own, go with Kenny, stay at Wellington, go with Kenny, leave with Kenny.
Yeah.
Those are the five permutations of the end game here. But at E3, it was announced there is a season 3, and it will be starring Clementine.
Oh, Clementine. Yeah, Clementine's back.
It'll be teenage Clementine with AJ, and somewhere along the line, she lost a finger.
Clementine?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's an older Clementine. It's a more rugged, badass Clementine. She's seen a lot of shit, and everyone is really curious how your last choices
are going to affect that third season.
Right. Because these are radically different directions. And not only do you split in radically different ways, you end up in radically different locations. Because you're either up in fucking Montana, where I think Wellington is. I think it's up in Montana. It's up in the north somewhere. Down in, like, northern South Carolina or South North Carolina at Howe's, or off God knows where in your own ending. Like, it's really easy between season one and season two.
Yeah, it's not far apart from one another.
Because the only big decisions in season one, season two is, do you leave Lee or do you shoot Lee? That's the big decision at the end. You always end up with Omid and Krista.
Imagine if in season one, you don't shoot Lee, and then somewhere along season three, you meet Lee's Walker corpse.
Oh, God. Oh, God, I would have to deal with that because I didn't shoot Lee.
Just imagine, though. I don't think that's going to happen. Yeah. I don't think it's going to happen, but imagine if it did.
But here's the thing that I didn't talk in this playthrough as much as I normally do, especially this episode, because I had to bite my tongue. Because aside from my occasional outbursts against Kenny, I didn't want to influence your decision too much.
Yeah.
I wanted you to get a pure experience with this, and I was fascinated with what your decision with Kenny was going to be, because more than anyone else I've seen with play this, you've been on board with Kenny. You're the only person I've seen.
Well, not to interrupt you.
Oh, no, please.
But it's not that I was on board with Kenny. It's that some of the decisions and some of his reasoning I agreed with. I do not agree with Kenny completely.
Yeah.
For starters, just about all the times, like with Carver and with Arvo, wrong place, wrong time, should have just not have done it or been done and been done and over with it instead of dragging it out and potentially, you know, putting people in harm. And you're right, I agree. Kenny is a very harmful person, but he was also the most experienced when it came to dealing with children.
Yeah.
And he also did have some good ideas, because like when Carver was taking everybody, you know, aside from him giving in when Sarita was in trouble, I agreed. I was just like, fuck it. We have no idea if he's going to kill everybody anyway. If we give up, we may as well go down fighting if we're going to die. And it's, you know, in the end, he was going to kill Kenny anyway.
Yeah.
And he might have killed everybody else. I mean, he pushed, what is it? I can't remember his name, but what's his face off the roof for fucking up on plants?
Yeah.
It's like, so.
Oh, no, Carver was the right decision. It's just, like, he couldn't tone it down. He couldn't pull it back.
Yeah, that's. Now, in the end, when I shot Kenny, my reasoning for that was, as again, agreeing with you, Kenny has gone off the rails a lot, and he's done it, and he has taken it pretty much to the extreme, where he does kill the person he goes off on the rails with. Jane, I haven't seen that much. Now, again, I agree with you. She's manipulative. The whole situation was shitty. The difference is that Kenny would have killed Jane, and if I went with him, it was extremely risky thinking about how long does he go off on the rails before he either kills AJ himself, whether it be willingly or accidentally, or more likely he goes off the rails, kills somebody, and AJ dies as a consequence.
Yeah. So the argument I see for all the people in favor of Kenny basically boils down to he does everything for the kids and he wouldn't go off the rails on me. And I cannot trust that.
Yeah, that's. I mean, it's like you saw it. Like it. Now, some of the people, again, with Arvo, with Carver, even though I don't agree with it, even though I don't say he should have done it then, I can understand why. But, like, when he was about to go off the rails with Ben, like, no.
Yeah.
That was. No, there was no reason for it. Thankfully, like, I don't think. Did he ever actually beat the shit out of Ben? Or did
no.
Yeah, he never actually beat the shit out of Ben, but he was like a paper thin's way from doing it.
He can beat the shit out of Ben. Your choices led him to not.
Yeah, so.
But he can.
Yeah, so there you go. He would have beaten the shit out of Ben if it wasn't for my choices. And like seeing like Ben, there was no, nothing good would have come of that. And that's just another instance of when Kenny would fly off the rails. So I don't see it as me really agreeing with either of them on their choices. Because, again, it was a shitty situation no matter what. And I see as Kenny was, he was kind of like a wounded dog. He needed to be put down.
Yeah.
Unlike you, I don't hate Kenny. And I do agree with some of the things he had, but he was wounded. He was being pushed over the edge. And unlike Jane, he can't really keep his cool. So Jane fucked up. And I'm hoping in season three, we get to address that at some point. But so far, she didn't have as many strikes as Kenny had.
The big thing I have against Kenny, and it very boils down to a very simple character flaw of his. When in a situation where shit hits the fan, he goes off and he attacks who he thinks the problem is. In situations like Carver, that's more acceptable because what he's attacking is the problem. But if the problem doesn't, the solution doesn't involve him attacking something, he becomes part of the problem.
Yeah.
And then he will turn around and blame it on someone else. And that drives me fucking insane. Yeah. It's just one of the things that, like, I cannot abide by that.
Yeah.
Especially in crisis situations.
I don't, I don't agree with Kenny in those situations, but I kind of empathize with him in a way because I understand where he's coming from. So,
well, at the same time, that's why I'm not as hard on Arvo, because I can empathize with him. Because, yeah, he's not a strong person, and he's surrounded by much tougher individuals. So I can very easily see it being, he went back, they asked him what happened, he told them, and they're like, we need to go fuck them up. And he probably wasn't on board with this. Then him being against Clementine, it's like, Clementine was the one to shoot his sister. She had turned into a zombie, sure. But, like, yeah, he's in a really bad spot, and then Kenny isn't giving him the ground to get his footing on and recover from that. Like I said, Arvo is still a shitty person, and him shooting Clementine is really fucking vile, but I can empathize with him a bit more than not at all.
For me, see, it's the other way around with me, with Arvo. I don't empathize with Arvo. I would agree with you on the sense that he didn't want anything bad to happen until he lied and said that they robbed him.
Yeah.
He let them, I chose to let them go, and no matter what, he says they robbed him. It's like, oh, so.
Yeah, that fucking sucks.
There's the first strike, and then the other strike is when he tries to run off. Even if he couldn't have gotten away, the intention is still there, the meaning is still there, and that was strike number two for me. And then he shot me, which me trying to talk Kenny off from beating the shit out of him, from letting him go with his supplies,
yeah,
and not shooting him with his fucking sister, you would think just a little bit of gratitude would have been given. He at least wouldn't have shot me.
Well, my argument is we don't know exactly why he ran on the ice. It could have been because he's trying to get away, sure. But it could also be he's fucking terrified because you're walking on thin ice and he wants to get out of there. It could be he's trying to get away from Kenny because Kenny is very quickly losing it and has shown he is more than happy to beat a prisoner.
Oh, yeah.
And then when he shoots you, it's like you shot a sister. You're on the team of the guy who will not stop beating him. And yeah, I can see why he has no sympathy for Clementine. Like, I still think it's a shitty thing to do, pulling the trigger when you're trying to talk the situation down, or worse, when you're unarmed, but I can see where he's coming from mentally. But, yeah, we can talk for hours on these characters.
I see why the message boards would explode on this.
Yeah, there's not a clear answer on this. What I'm hoping with season three is episode one, we get at least the first half of episode one, four or five different variations for the different openings. Think like the first missions in Dragon Age Origins. And then from there,
it kind of converges
into a single line.
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. That's probably the most realistic way it's going to happen. Because otherwise, they'd have to essentially make two separate games.
Yeah. Well, they would have to make more than two. What I really hope doesn't happen is whatever brings these five threads back together doesn't happen off screen.
Yeah, I want to see, like, I'm imagining that no matter what happens, you either leave Jane or Kenny no matter what, and I'm hoping they show why.
Yeah. And I hope it's leave and not they die. That'd be kind of shitty.
Yeah, I don't think they'll do that, though, because it seemed like Kenny was going to fucking die. And I also thought the old man and his bitch brigade were going to die, which we barely got anything of. Which also, by the way, reminds me, No, we never got anything with Krista. We have no confirmation if she's dead or alive.
I fully expect to see her in season 3 because with the rules of this game, as we've seen with Kenny, if you don't see them die on screen, they're not dead.
I want to kill Bonnie. I really want to kill Bonnie. Like, I know I said it before, and then I gave her a second chance, but she's kind of like the preliminary and also post-Arvo for me. Yeah, I've given her chances. It's like, now I want to kill her.
Well, she fucked up with her group in 400 days. She fucked up with Carver. She got Luke killed. Then she blamed it on you.
Had a Kenny moment there.
And then she was complicit. Yeah, Bonnie... Like, Barney is a real hardcore fuck-up. And up until she blames it on you, I'm kind of there with her, like, it's not our fault, it's not our fault. Then she blames it on you, it's like, okay, you've crossed that line. Go fuck yourself.
How dare you berate my beloved Orange?
Well, it's not even that. She has now shown that she makes mistakes. She realizes she makes mistakes. But then she tries to pawn responsibility of those mistakes off on other people.
Yeah.
And fuck that.
Yeah.
But that's...
I'm kind of expecting, like, the next time we see Bonnie, she's gonna be like, oh, yeah, I killed Mike.
Yeah. Yeah, Mike and Arvo died for unrelated reasons. Yeah.
So,
That's Walking Dead.
That's Walking Dead Season 2. We'll see you next time when we step back into the world of survival horror.